The Carolina Thunderbirds are on the air, and it's time for the Labatt Blue Coaches Show on the home of Thunderbirds Hockey, WTOB. Tonight's show is brought to you by Labatt Blue, Get Undomesticated, McAnally's, home of the 45-cent wing nut, every Monday and Wednesday. Forsyth Tech, break away from the pack. Oaks Animal Hospital, dogs, cats, and Thunderbirds, they fix them all. By BJ's Restaurant and Brew House, home of the world-famous Pizookie Dessert. Fettigan's Wake, the Triad's favorite Irish pub and eatery. King's Hot Dogs, home of the King Dog. As Good As It Gets, the official salsa provider of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Carlisle's Pub, your friendly neighborhood tavern. Britton Chiropractic, the official chiropractor of the Thunderbirds. By Washington Park Barbershop, located at 2104 Broad Street in Winston-Salem. And by Pat's Body Shop and Towing, the official towing provider of the Thunderbirds and the Fairgrounds Annex. Now let's go live to head coach Andre Nietzsche, the round mound of sound Scott Brand, and the voice of the Carolina Thunderbirds, Zach DeBozart.
Good evening, flock. Welcome in to the WTOB studios on Tuesday, April 2nd. It's now time for the Labatt Blue Coaches Show. I'm Zach DeBozart, Andre Nietzsche, Scott Brand, all in studio. No player guest, unfortunately, on this show. We've got more PR going out this time of year. I understand the boys are playing a youth team. Isn't that correct, Scott?
They're playing two, since hockey's grown so much. Can I get that swing mic back? Since hockey's grown so much, they now have two teams.
All right, well, just pass these over here. We got a mic issue here in studio,
well,
so.
This is not comfortable.
No, that's true. It's not.
Oh, my. In the okay.
While we sort out these great on-air production meetings.
Here we go. Okay, so listen. We've got hockey's exploded here. And so there's two teams. So, yes, tonight we have 10 or 11, 12 guys over at the Annex. And the report I just got is we're already losing.
Oh, good. Good start.
To the Winston Mites.
Well, clearly we used up.
Poor coaching.
Well, clearly we used
up. Hey, I'm not there, so.
Clearly,
it's not my coaching.
Clearly we used up all of our goals this weekend and haven't saved any for the youth teams because, guys, there's a lot to cover. 25 goals in three games. And before we get into what everyone wants to talk about, the Saturday-Sunday games, we've got to talk about Friday first.
I don't want to talk about Saturday and Sunday until we talk about Friday because, you know.
It's just how things worked out because.
53 minutes, we were caca, as they say south of the border.
Thunderbirds were down 4-1 in the latter stages of the third period.
Yeah, and I talked to the players and they said it's your fault.
Oh.
Why? Because we got there too early?
No. Because we ate too much food.
Oh, that's right. I got to pick the meal on Friday.
Oh, okay.
So
all right.
When Big Daddy's in town picking the meal, we got a real good deal on lunch at Golden Corral.
Uh-huh.
And
so you're telling me that's the reason why the boys were a little sluggish?
Oh, were they sluggish?
That's what they said. They said, we ate too much.
Yes. Particularly the sweets.
Oh, yeah. So yeah. That was crazy.
We have a Czech defenseman. Now your microphone needs.
Now this microphone's done.
Your microphone needs Viagra. You better stop by Marley Drug. So
hold on. Does this mean, Scott, that we can blame you for another overtime loss to Port Huron?
Absolutely, you can blame me.
Wow, two of them this year.
Hold the arm.
Why don't you put that one over there and put this one here?
That's okay.
Swing the red one
around.
Put
your arm.
Like this. Yeah. There you go.
Okay. Can you guys hear me?
There you go. Yeah.
Perfect.
Okay. Anyway.
They all do the same thing.
Scott?
So where was I at? Oh, we ate too much. Yeah, so we lost in overtime. Actually, we played a real good 7 minutes.
So if we can recap, 4-1.
Ate too much.
And goals from Michael Bunn, Ray Boudiette, and then Josh Petrantonio with 6 seconds left to go in the game. Karel Drarod, a shot from the left point. And, Scott, we missed it on the call because we were sort of blinded to the action. But on the backside of the play, Petrantonio just put in a beautiful tip, bloomed the net, and it was 4-4. And I hesitate to say the place was erupting because we were in Port Huron, but we probably had about 50 or 60 traveling fans that made that place loud for us.
That is true.
Well, yeah, you had Josh's family, so there's 45 of his immediate family. And, of course, your family was there, my family was there, and then we have flock that follows us, and And so it was, it was a real good, and the girls came up from our concession, came up, and so it was really good. I mean, listen, you know, was it the week before that we scored against Watertown late, and then we have that dramatic goal. I mean,
it was Elmira.
It was Elmira.
Yeah.
And so, it was good to see us come back. Unfortunately, listen, Chase Fallis took a penalty in overtime. I thought it was a smart penalty to take.
It was.
You know.
I agree.
So, just you got to do something, and it didn't go our way that much. And then, so that's the way it goes. Andre, you weren't happy with the first 53 minutes at all.
That's right.
And then I made a wish on a star for the next day.
Took a minute and a half into that overtime period and 6 seconds into that Fallis penalty for Dalton Jay to put in his 42nd. And 5-4, Prowlers win, and they had to be feeling good about themselves because at that time they were still in a battle for third place against Watertown.
You have to give it to them. You know, they beat us. You know, they tried to do the bird. You know, like, I don't know if you saw it.
The flying V.
The flying V, you know, and then you get beat 11-2, day, you know. So you watch out what you do.
So at that time, Port Huron, they were fighting for third spot, and then we were actually reviewing the film because we got all the film goes on to tape delay on WSTV, which, by the way, Flock, tonight you will see our Elmira last second buzzer beater, and then tomorrow you'll see the Port Huron game we're talking about here. But Scott, I found this interesting. We were reviewing film on the Saturday game. You mentioned, I feel like not even a minute into the game broadcast, you hope we beat the tires off of them. And we ended up doing that 11-2. But what was your thought on that first, making that comment?
Listen, he's talking about Saturday now.
Yeah, Saturday.
We thought you were still talking about Friday.
Yeah.
No, I transitioned.
You should usually put a commercial. We got to start having these promotions.
This show is off the rails.
We have got to quit. Yeah, we got to have these promotional meetings and stop having them at the bar. So, okay. So, Saturday, yes, we got on. And here's my issue. Is the last thing we want to do is show that the birds are beatable. And we are, and no disrespect to the other five teams, but I think that I thought it was personally important that, you know, Port Huron beat us. We probably figured we were going to play them in the first round. I thought it was extremely important to go out and send a message, and I don't mean send a message by fighting and all that garbage that Elmira does. I'm talking about sending a message that, listen, we're the dominant, we're the daddy here, we're the big man, and we're going to show you who the big man is. And so, I frankly, I love it. I thought it was absolutely wonderful. We pretty much scored at will. We took advantage. Now, we did give up, we gave up some stuff that Andre can go over and fix, but that's what we needed. Because I think everybody looked at Saturday and thought, okay, well, I guess you don't beat the, if you beat the birds on Friday, you really peed in their Wheaties, and we need to, you know, make sure that we don't embarrass the birds.
But like how you said, you know, like, again, you know, like, I think that was a wake-up call for the whole team, you know, and because I think the last time that we lost, you know, it was 9 games back, and we didn't lose for 9 games, so let's continue like that, you know. My thing is, players have to realize, you know, like, it's tough because right now, you know, the games, they don't mean anything more. We broke another record or two or three. I don't even know anymore.
We're losing count.
Yeah, we're losing count, and it's not really important anymore, you know, like breaking records, but is prepare yourself for the playoffs.
That's right.
And guys need to realize it's not about scoring goals anymore. It's about good defense, you know, protecting your net, you know. Don't give the other team an inch, you know. In your zone, you know, in the danger zone, and play good, simple hockey. And I think when we hit playoffs, you know, guys will realize that because we have some good quality players that will step up and say, hey, man, you know, you got to play better.
Your scoring summary from that Saturday 11-2 game starts with Panacek, then goes Bunn, Petrantonio, Vlasov, and then Pargach. That goal was 0.3 seconds left. That one to me just seemed like the ultimate backbreaker and really told me that Carolina was going to have a good game. So 5 different goal scorers in period number one. Then we go Fallis, Petrantonio, Bunn, Boudiette, Robertson got one in there, and then Fallis again before Giuliano and Fallis traded in the third period. So Chase Fallis, another hat trick for him on the year. Congratulations to that. And just look up and down, Andre, all sorts of goals.
But that's the thing, you know, like if you would have only one guy who scores all the goals, you know, like, all right, perfect. I'm gonna get a good defensive player on him, you know, and he's gonna skate with him wherever he goes, you know. If he goes to the bathroom, he's gonna stay with him in the bathroom. But we got 15, 16 guys that can score goals, you know. Right now, when we have all our guys on the ice, everyone can score a goal, and I think that's the most important thing, you know. We don't have one line, we don't have two lines, we got three lines.
Seven different goal scorers in that game, and four different guys with 4+ points. Petr Antonio, 2 goals and 2 helpers. Fallas, the hat trick and a helper. Panacek, 1 goal, 3 assists, and then Yuri Pargach, 1 goal, 4 assists for 5 points. And that wasn't even his best night on the weekend.
He had a great weekend, you know, like he had 11 points in 3 games, you know, like, again, you know, like, you gotta think he didn't even play all the games this year, you know, like, I think he should have been Rookie of the Year, you know, in my eyes, because, what that kid showed, you know, and how he plays every night, he would have deserved it. But the thing is, again, he can claim it next year, because, since the Rookie of the Year from this year played last year, you know, and didn't have all those games, you know, so maybe Pargy comes back, but we're going to have meetings, you know, or like after the season, and then we'll find out who the players are that are coming back or who are retiring and who is going somewhere else. So,
well, before we get into Sunday's game, we got to take a break. When we come back, we'll talk about that game 10-2 over the Danville Dashers, and we'll look a little bit ahead to the finale weekend once again against the Danville Dashers. This is the Labatt Blue Coaches Show on WTOB.
I bringeth thee a message from... a message from the king and his new trumpeteer, Stephen. The king wishes me to convey his favor to thine team and thine tailgate. Not yet. He invites thee to let the Bud Light flow forth. And he also wishes me to tell thee that he toasts thee. Waiteth until the end, Stephen! With game day's favorite light lager and the slogan of his kingdom... Oh, dilly dilly!
Enjoy responsibly, Bud Light Beer, AB, St. Louis, Missouri.
What the cluck? Macanelli's is the home of the 45-cent chicken wings every Monday and Wednesday, dine-in only.
Plus, enjoy live music and karaoke. Come in for Macanelli's other weekly dining specials. Tuesday's all-you-can-eat pasta night, $9.95 at half-price wine. Thursday, $5 classic burger night. And Macanelli's is now serving brunch Friday, Saturday, and Sunday from 11 a.m. till 2 p.m. at 4926 Country Club Road at Harper Hill Commons in Winston-Salem. Eat, drink, enjoy, cluck.
With a commitment to practice excellence and a kind, caring, and compassionate staff, Oaks Animal Hospital looks forward to caring for your furry family members. They provide many different services, including wellness visits, dentistry, dietary consults, and much more. Give them a call at 336-986-9388 or visit for a consultation at 151 Vinegar Hill Road. And when you visit their website, oaks.vet, you can save $5 off on your appointment when you check in with Facebook. That's oaks.vet.
At our table, craft means everything. It's where a one-of-a-kind brewhouse experience has been perfected for 40 years. Where over 120 delicious items are perfectly paired with award-winning handcrafted beer.
Oh, I gotta try that.
And the only place where you can top it all off with our world-famous Pizookie dessert. It's at BJ's Restaurant and Brewhouse, where there's a moment on every plate and a memory at every table. Visit BJsRestaurants.com.
As good as it gets. From the small town of Germantown, North Carolina, comes fresh and delicious homemade salsa. They offer regular chunky salsa and black bean and corn salsa. Both varieties available in mild, medium, hot, and butt burner. Butt burner salsa is only available in regular chunky and is made with jalapenos, habaneros, and Carolina Reaper peppers. All natural ingredients, never any preservatives. Always fresh from our kitchen to you. That's as good as it gets.
Don't miss the Carolina Thunderbirds closing out the 2018-19 regular season at home against the Danville Dashers this Saturday night. It's Fan Appreciation Night, and the first 1,500 fans through the door get a free team poster. The Thunderbirds have clinched the number one seed in the FHL playoffs and are now looking to close the season on a high note. Tickets are on sale at the Fairgrounds box office or by searching Carolina Thunderbirds on Ticketmaster. And as always, parking is free to every Carolina Thunderbirds home game. Carolina Thunderbirds hockey, built for speed.
WTOB Studios, Zach DeBozart, Scott Brand, Andre Nietzsche stepped out for just a moment. He'll be right back. Carolina Thunderbirds pick up 7 of 9 points. That's weird to say, Scott, after the weekend we had where we scored 25 goals and, of course, coming off back-to-back double-digit performances. But as we mentioned in that opening segment, the overtime loss, that really just kind of that kind of made the Birds pretty mad, didn't it?
Pete and Arweedy's, no question about it. It got everybody fired up, and, you know, I think we needed it. I actually think that that's probably a great turning point because, you know, we're going to play Port Huron again. In the first round, I think that we probably got a little bit cocky, if I can say that, or a little arrogant, and we needed to get knocked down. So that loss was probably the best thing in the world. And then you know, we recap Saturday, and then Sunday was the same. I forgot to tell the boys they could turn it down a notch, and they absolutely dismantled Danville.
That they did, a 10-2 victory over the Danville Dashers. As we look at it, the goals came in spurts again. They came in spurts a bit in Port Huron, but even more so in Danville. The first two goals come in about a minute and a half span between Petrantonio and Panacek. Panacek scores again about midway through the period, and then here was the ultimate backbreaker. Just like Pargach's goal with 0.3 seconds left in the first in Port Huron, 7 seconds after Panacek's second goal in Danville, Peshtuka just turns the defense over, rips it top shelf. And the end of the period was 4-0, but I think at that point you could just tell Danville and their crowd, they were quite deflated. And, I mean, giving up 2 goals in 7 seconds, that's going to do that to you.
Well, it does kill you, and particularly when you've been bounced out of the playoffs, and it's what do you got left to fight for? And unfortunately or fortunately, I guess we got them again this weekend. So we'll look at those games ahead. But, you know, what was nice is that Frankie got a start. He played extremely well. I think he let 2 goals in, and he'll admit that one of the goals was kind of soft, but he made some pretty big saves.
He really did. Frankie ends up getting the win in this one. He got 42 saves on 44 shots, so that's going to help boost the save percentage a little bit there, too. Looking at the rest of the scorers, it was Ray Boudiette, then Sam Turner got his first as a Danville Dasher to respond. Peshtuka, his second. Pargach won to end the period. Then Fallis, who was just on fire as well this weekend with 4 goals in his last 2 games. Fred Hine lasered one before Pargach and Petrantonio each got on the board with their second of that game. And once again, this time, 6 different goal scorers for 10 as Andre Nietzsche comes back in. And just an overall dominant team effort on Sunday.
You know what? I think the boys played well, but, you know, again, we got scored on twice. The one goal, I think there was a mistake on the blue line, a misunderstanding. But Frankie had a good game. You know, I like that Frankie is getting in the net, you know, and giving us a couple games because it's very important to have, you know, a backup goalie that also played. You know, if you need him to play, he's going to play. And you know what, Frankie did a big jump, you know, from last year to this year, you know, like, how many games did he play, 10?
He is up at the 10 games right now with a 9-0 record.
9-0 record, you know, he had that one game where he got changed, but, you know, like, sometimes you have a bad day, that's the way it is, but I think Frankie's grown into a good goalie, you know, like, I think he needs one more year, and he will be right there.
And for the record, for the flock listening in, we wanted to get Frankie on the show, but because we have all of our players at the Mites game, we needed goalies, obviously.
Yeah, we needed a goalie, and Frankie stepped up. And,
especially considering our losing streak to those guys.
He told me it was a contract dispute.
Okay, sure, it was a contract dispute. To your point, Coach, though, I wanted to bring this up because since that game where Frankie got pulled, and you know, you're right, everyone has their bad games. Everyone, you know, has a night they'd like to forget. But I really like how Frankie's responded after that game because I believe he's had 3 starts since then. And you look, and he's given up 2 goals or less in every single one.
Oh, look at his, you know, goals against percentage.
Yep, goals against average. Yeah.
Average. Sorry. Average, it's 2.6.
Yeah, 2.56 right now.
You know, like those are great stats. You know, I think he's second in the league. You know, after Pavlis. You know, so
he might be.
He is. Like if you look at it, you know, he really is. So he's doing a good job. You know, and I think again, you know, like as a goalie, I'm gonna say that to every goalie out there. You know, who wants to be a goalie and everything. You got to be a phlegmatic. You know, we have a bad game, forget about it. And, you know, next day you're ready to go again. You know.
That's right. And for the numbers here, March 1st is when he was pulled, and we won in overtime, so he didn't get credit for the loss. Patches coming in got the win there. And then he had a 7-2 win against Menor on March 15th, a 2-1 win against Elmira. That was the buzzer beater, the March 23rd. I thought he played very well, really, in the first two periods.
He played very well.
And he only had to face one shot in the third. That's how strong we were on the forecheck in the third period. And then two goals on 44 shots against Danville, the highest shot output he's seen all year, and really since he's been in the FHL, actually, outside of one game in 2017. So he's been on a phenomenal run since that, and I think you're right. He's really bounced back from it well.
Yeah, like how I said, you know, he needs time to develop. You know, everybody's different. Everybody says goalies develop when they're 20, 21. No, it's not true. You know, like if you talk to scouts in the NHL or wherever, you know, they tell you a good goalie is all grown up or experienced when he's 27. That's what I would say. So, again, Frankie does a good job. You know, he deserves it, and I'm happy to have him here.
So,
Did we have a caller?
No, it's light from that.
Yeah, that's the sunlight messing up with you there.
I thought it was the same thing.
So a 10-2 victory on Sunday after an 11-2 victory on Saturday. And Coach, I'm curious your thoughts here before we put the bow on the weekend there. You mentioned, you know, two goals in each game. Obviously, you know, you don't want that to happen, and there's some mistakes that were probably made. What about the shot totals? 33 in that Saturday game against Port Huron, 44 against Danville on Sunday. More so than the goals, were you concerned that a lot of shots were getting through?
Yeah, I didn't really like that. But the thing is, the reason why that really happened is because we just played an open game, you know. Like, everybody just wanted to, you know, bring up points, you know, have an assist. And the thing is, like, this can't happen, you know. Like, we could have to play a lot better defense, you know, like blocking shots, not letting players in. And then when we had some dumb penalties, you know, like, and, you know, on the power play, if you take shots, that's the way it is. But, like, I would like to have around 17 to 20 shots, you know, against us. So that's that's how I see it, maybe even less.
Yeah, that's a good number to look at it there for defensive goals. So the Thunderbirds take 7 out of 9 points on the weekend. During this weekend, we broke the FHL's record for best points percentage. So the number for us, based on the games played and the amount of points you can possibly earn, we needed to be over, I believe, was 84%. Right now, we're at about 87. And basically, once we got past 144, there was no way we could drop lower than Port Huron's percentage last year when they set the mark. So once again, there's another record in the books for the Thunderbirds.
Is there any record we haven't? Least losses.
That is going to take a lot of digging, especially during this week, as we're getting through the video slog, and it seems like every week there's going to be a new thing to research there. So it's something we're working on for sure.
And of course, the thing we don't want is to be a Port Huron where you break all the records and then lose in the first round.
That's right. We don't want that
championship. Yeah, they lose.
It was a championship. Finals. Yeah.
Like again, you know, where were we? I just got lost.
We were in Danville.
No, we were talking about the records.
Oh, the records.
You know? Like, I think we had more records. Wasn't that the most games won in a season?
That's right. We had the most wins of any team.
And then between goals.
Longest winning streak.
Longest winning streak.
I think we might be on pace for the goals against record of teams that have played a full season. That's a record you have to qualify because, you know, if you only play 3 games, you only give up 7 goals. That's not the record. So,
You got the goalies, you know, like I think most shutouts in the league.
Yep, Patches has 5 shutouts for the most individual, and then Henry Dill's 2 makes 7, which I think is the most of any FHL team, full stop. So again, the research team has to get down and dirty with these.
All right, we'll call Al.
Looking ahead to this weekend's games, we got 2 to finish out a home-and-home series. In Friday night, we're in Danville. Saturday night, we're back here in Winston-Salem. Scott, we got to do the PR to start with right away. There's only about 500 tickets left for our Saturday finale, our fan appreciation night, of course, brought to you by WTOB.
Yeah, if you're planning on going, you might want to get tickets. So, and that night, then you can buy tickets. Excuse me, something came up. You know what? We're all catching a cold because of the blizzard they had today.
Yeah,
but smoking. But we came up. What the hell was I saying now?
Fan appreciation night.
Yeah, we were
before we were rudely derailed.
Yeah, by So it's a big night. There's only 500 tickets left. And, of course, if you want to buy playoff tickets, they go on sale that Friday.
April 5th. And that's also the public availability for our season ticket dates. You can get your full season tickets, 336-774-4625, starting on April 5th. If you're in the public, if you're a current season ticket holder.
You better have them.
Yeah, your period to renew is currently going on right now. And to guarantee your seat, April 5th is that cutoff. So that's coming up here pretty soon. But and the first 1,500 fans are getting team posters. Of course, courtesy of WTOB as well. We took those pictures about a couple weeks ago, so it's going to be exciting to see those in print.
Yeah, after Dr. Trade here got done with all his... That was the best laugh.
That really was.
That was the best laugh. There is one missing problem with that picture, but maybe we can Photoshop... a certain person that was left out.
Yeah, we'll see if we can.
If not, we'll just get a picture and stamp Willie on there.
Nah, there it is. So Friday night in Danville, it's a 7:05 Central puck drop, which is 8:05 here in the East, and then turn it back around nice and quick for a 6:05 Eastern puck drop. Wonder who made that schedule.
Whoever likes to sell out the building because it's working, right? Listen, the back-to-backs, and you
we're
know...
Yeah, we're playing at 6 on Saturday.
Wow. Yeah, we're playing at 6. Now, next week, the week after I gave you a break, because I'm pushing that game all the way back to 7.
That's right.
So, but you know what? This is why I prepared the schedule like this, because I knew what was going to happen in the playoffs. That's why. Listen, we'll get back. First of all, we have a sleeper bus. So before all those people think I'm a cruel, heartless SOB.
Which you might be.
Which I am. Because it saves me money. So we'll go up.
I was just thinking that. Save me money.
Now he's a mind reader.
Save me money.
Listen, we leave Thursday night. We're going to leave here about 10 o'clock, maybe 11. We'll get to Danville, 9 o'clock in the morning. He might skate him. Okay, so we'll have a light skate. We'll get breakfast. We'll go to the hotel. We'll take our pregame. So we'll be at the hotel by noon. We'll take our pregame nap. Good 4 hours. We'll get up. We'll shower. We'll head to the rink and go play. That's exactly how it is. And we have a sleeper bus.
That's true. That is true. Scott, Andre,
you're the most comfortable sleeper bus with working lights now.
That's right.
We're actually in compliance with is it FCC? Who does the travel? Or FTC? Or whatever.
For those in the flock wondering, he means working lights inside the bus. He does not mean working headlights. We've had those all year.
No, but we didn't have all the lights to tell you how tall you are and where the back of it. There may have been some lights that were skewed.
Before Scott further...
Because they were burned.
Before
out.
Scott further perjures himself here, Andre, real quick, before we go to break...
Oh, we got breaks, too.
Yes, we have those,
too. We just got him, man, the last two games.
Cost us a grand.
Yeah, you know what? You guys earned them.
Got new headlights. Grand.
Haven't earned those yet.
New horn. Grand.
New horn. Grand.
All right, know? Andre, your thoughts on the back-to-back and just some of the strategies, especially this late in the year. I mean, we saw this weekend you were resting guys. You brought 19 on the trip, so you can always have a guy on rest.
Don't say that loud.
Yeah, you just violated the FHL rule.
No, he didn't, but again, you know.
What are you doing this weekend?
What are you doing this weekend? I'm going to play maybe 13 guys.
There you go.
Sounds like Danville might too. So we're gonna go to Danville.
We're gonna go to Danville. Like how you said, we get ready. You know, play the game, and I'm gonna maybe leave a couple guys home.
Right. And then Saturday night, obviously, we're at home. Sellout crowd. All the players will be introduced, and we'll do what we did last year with the little guys, little mites. Where we give them our jerseys, and they skate out, and they trip and fall and hit their head on the ice.
You mean the ones that are currently mercilessly beating us right now
in
the ice?
They probably are. I don't even know what's going
like
on.
Like 7-0 right now,
you know,
or whatever it is.
Last week, the girls, they were swinging their stick.
You know what? I don't know if they're winning because, like, Stan Vlasov is playing.
Ooh. So, yeah, well, you know what?
I'm sure there are a couple fights already.
After the benches clearing brawl during the girls' game, it's good to bring in Stan, really, you know, hold down law and order.
Stan might miss Friday. He probably broke his arm again on some 7-year-old. But it's Saturday night will be special because again we do have the youth come out. We give the little kids our jerseys, so they're huge on them. So they look cute and they get up and they skate on the blue. I just remember that was probably one of my favorite pictures last year, just to watch how hockey goes from that might, which again have to have two games or playing cross ice because there's so many guys and. And listen, that's the Thunderbirds, man. That's bringing hockey back. And then watch those little kids, how cute they are. And I got to tell you what, it's easy for me to say this because we you know, won so many games. I as much as I care or don't care about winning, the fact that Andre brought these young men, some of them kids too, and they can, the way they congregate, not congregate, work with the youth and the community, just amazing. And that's what's going to make, to me, Saturday night, just that lineup on the blue line with all those kids and all of our kids and lots of kids, and then go out and shellac Danville and probably cheap shot some people.
There you go. All right, let's take a break here. The Labatt Blue Coaches Show rolls on after this on the Carolina Thunderbirds Radio Network.
At our table, craft means everything. It's where a one-of-a-kind brew house experience has been perfected for 40 years. Where over 120 delicious items are perfectly paired with award-winning handcrafted beer.
Oh, I gotta try that.
And the only place where you can top it all off with our world-famous Pizookie dessert. It's at BJ's Restaurant and Brew House, where there's a moment on every plate and a memory at every table. Visit BJsRestaurants.com.
Pat's Body Shop and Towing, the official towing provider for the Thunderbirds and the Fairgrounds, is your single source for automotive excellence in the Triad. Exceptional collision repair, 24-hour towing, interior work, mechanical, custom painting, and restoration. 5720 Country Club Road, Winston-Salem. Call 336-945-3767. For 24-hour towing, call 336-999-3000. When you think automotive, think Pat's Body Shop and Towing.
It's an Ardmore neighborhood favorite, Carlisle's Pub on 1314 South Hawthorne Road in Winston-Salem. Open 4 p.m. to 2 a.m. Mondays through Saturdays, and open 4 p.m. to midnight on Sundays. Come on in for great atmosphere, classic bar food, and great drink specials. That's Carlisle's Pub, 1314 South Hawthorne Road in Winston-Salem. Or give them a call, 336-723-5550.
King's Hot Dogs at 1009 Bethania Rural Hall Road. The King has been serving up his world-famous dogs for over three decades, and they'd like to invite you to stop by and give them a try. Located in the garden spot of the world, Rural Hall, North Carolina. Simply take Highway 52 to the Rural Hall Bethania exit and turn into the Village Square Shopping Center just around the corner. King's Hot Dogs, home of the King Dog. 336-969-4688. Open from 10 a.m. to 9 p.m. Monday through Saturday.
In 2006, Finnegan's Wake opened with the goal of helping revitalize Trade Street, creating a meeting place for the community, and adding some Irish flavor to Winston-Salem. We make all menu items from scratch with real fresh ingredients and strive to bring you a varied and interesting selection of drafts and cocktails as well. We close every night hoping we made everyone who comes into Finnegan's Wake feel like a part of our family. That is the true spirit of a real Irish pub. Located at 620 North Trade Street in Winston-Salem, open daily from 11 a.m. to 2 a.m.
Bring your group out for a Carolina Thunderbirds home game. Groups of 15 or more will get a ticket discount, added perks, and a night out to remember. Bring your school, church, company, team, or just a group of friends and enjoy all the Thunderbirds action this season. To reserve your group or for more information, call 336-774-8882 or visit CarolinaThunderbirds.com for more details.
Back here again on the Labatt Blue Coaches Show, WTOB 980 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming online, WTOB980.com. I'm Zach DeBozart, Scott Brand, Andre Nietzsche here in studio. Well, we've talked a lot about the last weekend that was, 25 goals in one weekend, only 7-9 points, which does feel weird to say, but I mean, I think it's kind of, that kind of tells the story more than anything, Scott. We were a little mad about Friday and really laid waste Saturday and Sunday.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, listen, it was great the way we came back and very good. You know, I think it's just part of the season, and it kind of shows you what the team's made of. It's the time we did make the mistake and got a little cocky, and you know, we decided 7 minutes later we could win this thing, and we almost did.
We almost did. Again, you know. Michael Bunn, Ray Boudiette, and Josh Petrangelo. You know, it's interesting. I was talking to a few people.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Well, we only had one hat trick this weekend.
But we had how many guys in hat trick alert?
We had
like six.
We had four on Saturday, or actually three on Saturday, four on Sunday. So I think seven.
Seven.
Yeah, it was a lot. It was, and in fact, I erroneously gave Chase Wallace a hat trick before he actually had it. So, even I was losing count.
You're clairvoyant.
Well, you know what? That's a good way to look at it. I appreciate the PR spin.
It was fun, and I'm not for running up scores. Yeah. Let's be honest.
Yeah, you are.
But I did like the fact that the last minute and a half, maybe on Sunday's game, guys who all had two goals and one guy who had no points at least got a chance to get on the ice.
Yeah, I believe it was Nolan, who doesn't have a goal yet. In fact, he had family in town on Sunday.
He's got 12 assists in 13 games.
Will he be up Friday?
I believe they said they would try and make the game. So
I think they're going to come up, yeah.
Yeah, so.
It's just a three-hour ride for them.
So. But Nolan and Pastuca were on defense. Pastuca obviously had his two, and then it was Pietrantonio, Pargach, and Panacek as your line, which honestly is a line you've used this weekend, and that's something to talk about.
They still couldn't score.
That's something to talk about.
I was even thinking about pulling the goalie.
We could call that the P line.
Yeah, that's something to talk about, Andre, because you were really mixing and matching a little bit. You said to me off the air that you wanted guys to be able to play with anybody.
You're right. You know, like this year, if you look at the D pairings that I did, you know, I switched everyone. You know, everybody played with everyone. Because the most important thing is you lose one guy, you got to switch sometimes. And then for me, if I put Stan Vlasov with Baker, they play together. If he plays with Domino, he plays with Domino. If he plays with Love, he plays with Love. Nobody cares. The most important thing is that they play together. You know, I don't like when people say, hey, I've never played with him. I can't play with him. I just can't play with him. Like, why? What's the difference? Hockey's hockey. System is system. You play the system. It doesn't matter who you play with. You know, of course, you get habits of looking over or somebody talking more to you or whatever. But my thing is, it doesn't matter who you play with. You got to play with everyone. That's the way it is.
And how did you feel about that this weekend? I mean, seeing all the different line combinations, and I'm sure you're going to be doing even more juggling coming up this weekend.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I'm going to try out some more guys. You know, we'll see if Joe Cangelosi will be back, you know, and I think Jake Henny will be back. Right now we got two games left, you know, and I'm going to reveal my playoff roster, you know, the next week, and whoever is healthy and ready to play will play. And again, you know, me and Scott will make the decision, you know, like, and we'll find the right mix of guys that will play.
Speaking of playoffs, we now have the full playoff schedule for the FHL, at least through the first round. Of course, Carolina Thunderbirds taking on the Port Huron Prowlers. So game one, we're back at McMorrin, 7 o'clock puck drop on Friday. Saturday, 7:05 puck drop. Scott graciously gave us an hour. So instead of our usual 6:05 Saturdays flock, you have to remember your playoff Saturdays will be 7:05.
That gives the fans more of an opportunity to tailgate. And it's still a 7 o'clock start, so for us old people, we can get to bed early.
And then an if-necessary game will be at the Winston-Salem Fairgrounds Annex Sunday, April 14th, 4:05 puck drop. That's when just business as usual, the 4 o'clock Sundays.
I was going to make it 1 o'clock to punish us just in case we were dumb enough to lose, but no, we're going to go 4:05.
But what if we had one game two? Is that still punishment?
I don't know.
By the way, for those interested, the Elmira and Watertown series starts in Watertown with a 7:30 puck drop at the Watertown Municipal Ice Arena, and then 7 o'clock Saturday at First Arena, and then 4:05, an if-necessary game on Sunday, April 14th. Before we break into our series, any thoughts on Elmira Watertown?
I want to ask Coach his thoughts on that series.
You know, I think it's going to be a tough series, and I wouldn't be surprised if Watertown gives Elmira a hard time, you know. Like, I think it's an even-up series, 50-50. That's what I think. Right now, you know, like, I'm going to focus more on Port Huron, but I'm going to be watching with one eye, you know, and see how they play.
To me, the prevailing storyline in this is obviously the trade, you know, right at the deadline, pretty much, of Lennartson and Yates from Watertown to Elmira, and now they're matched up, and you know, I'm kind of with Andre. It might be 50-50, especially given how Elmira played against the Menor Icebreakers. In the game they won on Sunday, which, okay, it was 6-4, probably, you know, people might think, Elmira might have more control than that, but Menor opened that game up 1-0. They already won one game that weekend, and if it wasn't for a rare, bizarre 10-minute power play, and Elmira jumps down their throat 4-1, even then, Menor came back 4-4. So, whatever.
Who played in net for Menor?
Fermenter, I believe it was Moser in that game.
And for Elmira?
Niedert. Niedert was in that Sunday game. I know
so
that for sure.
So they're resting
passing him, probably. But either way you look at it, I thought Menner gave Elmira quite a series, and I'm not saying you should speculate anything off that, but I think Elmira and Watertown are going to be fairly close, and obviously Lennartson and Yates, it gives me a real Marian Hossa vibe, if anyone remembers that saga in the late 2000s where Hossa was a senator, and then all of a sudden he's like, well, I'm going to try and go get a cup. He goes with Pittsburgh. They lose to Detroit. Then he goes to Detroit, try to get a cup. Then Detroit loses to Pittsburgh. You know, it could be sort of that thing.
Well, I think I think first of all, if memory serves me correct, I think that Elmira has a 3-game week. I mean, aren't they playing Thursday or something like that?
No, that Thursday game is actually Menner and Watertown.
Okay, that's I meant
Watertown. He meant Watertown.
Yeah.
That and here's my thing, is listen, anything I put on social media is strictly comedy, right? I think everybody who knows me and who sees the stuff I put out, I don't take anything serious. I'm one of those guys. Hey, life is a quick show, and we better have as much fun as possible. Mentor's already come up with some stupid logo or some stupid idea for Fear Embrace the Hate or something like
Elmira,
that.
Elmira.
They've already come up with some stupid thing like that, which, whatever. They're already talking about the next round, the championship round. They've already looked past Watertown. I'm going to tell you right now, I know Andre, I know our team. Yes, we're playing Port Huron. Port Huron, the only reason Port Huron was mentioned on this radio show is because we played them last week. Right now, we got to focus on Danville. I wouldn't be surprised to see Elmira upset this weekend, and all of a sudden people start backpedaling. And in the back of your mind, you're like, whoa, we got beat by Mentor. We barely squeaked past them in another game. You know, it was a close game here. And Passingham can win hockey games. He proved that to us.
Mm-hmm.
And so,
but Rutledge as well, you know.
Yeah, and Rutledge.
So that's the thing, you know. Like, you got two good goalies, you know, heading into the series, Watertown and Mara, and I think it's going to be an interesting series. And if somebody thinks, our team's already in the finals, no. You have to battle. Playoff is playoff. You know, like, you never know what's going to happen. It's a totally different season.
I mean, look, we're 51 minutes into the show, and people, we're just now talking about the playoffs because we got Danville coming up this weekend. I mean, you're not even in the playoffs yet. You still got a whole weekend to play and figure things out.
No, and it's focus. And, you know, again, I don't want to say these games mean nothing to us. They mean a lot in terms of some player points. They mean a lot in terms of us preparing for the playoffs. But you're right. I think that in some of the stuff I see comes out at some point, I just shake my head. You know, you have to approach this game with humility. Otherwise, the hockey gods will, and I believe in hockey gods, that they'll kick you right in the butt. And when, you know, just when you think everything's perfect, you know, you'll get a stick in the katukish.
And I think another thing too, before we head to break, is not only for player points, but player positioning. I mean, Andre said he's revealing the playoff roster in a little bit, and I mean, whether guys think they're securely on that or not, you know, there's some up and down even within the roster. You know, if you want to be on the specific line or on this pairing, I mean, look, Andre's going to be shuffling guys out all weekend anyways, but to me it just seems like it's going to be it's always a battle, internal or external, and I think internal is more the battle this weekend. We got to take a break. We'll wrap up the coaches show next on WTOB.
Hear ye. I bringeth thee a message from... a message from the king and his new trumpeter, Stephen. The king wishes me to convey his favor to thine team and thine tailgate. Not yet. He invites thee to let the Bud Light flow forth. And he also wishes me to tell thee that he toasts thee. Waiteth until the end, Stephen! With game day's favorite light lager and the slogan of his kingdom... Dilly Dilly!
Enjoy responsibly. Bud Light Beer, AB, St. Louis, Missouri.
Serving Winston-Salem, Greensboro, and surrounding areas, the welcoming team at Britton Chiropractic Center are committed to providing solutions to address your unique needs. Whether you are experiencing back pain, neck pain, headaches, or even muscular tightness and tension, if you're looking to improve your overall health, their chiropractors can help you attain your everyday wellness goals. Visit them in Winston-Salem at 205 South Stratford Road or call to set up a consultation, 336-293-8931.
It's time to rethink education. Hands-on, debt-free, from high schoolers unsure of next steps to students looking for a new career, the path to success starts at Forsyth Tech. Our cutting-edge courses and experienced instructors prepare our students for whatever's next, giving them clear pathways to learn and achieve their dreams with a timeline and cost that fits the real world. Experience an education that creates opportunities. Find your path to success at Forsyth Tech.
Washington Park Barbershop at 2104 South Broad Street. Full-time barbers offering precise cuts and detailed grooming with warm lather and hot towels used on every adult cut. Walk-in clients and kids welcome, plus local craft beer flowing on tap. An experience not to be missed here in Winston-Salem. Give them a call at 336-971-7827 or walk right in at 2104 South Broad Street. And again, that number, 336-971-7827.
What the cluck?
Macanelli's is the home of the 45-cent chicken wings every Monday and Wednesday, dine-in only.
Plus, enjoy live music and karaoke. Come in for Macanelli's other weekly dining specials. Tuesday's all-you-can-eat pasta night, $9.95 at half-price wine. Thursday, $5 classic burger night. And Macanelli's is now serving brunch Friday, Saturday, and Sunday from 11 a.m. till 2 p.m. at 4926 Country Club Road at Harper Hill Commons in Winston-Salem. Eat, drink, enjoy, cluck.
Don't miss any of the action when the Carolina Thunderbirds are home during the 2018-19 season. Right side to Martin, centering attempted front, blue lines on score! Great ticket packages are still available by calling 336-774-GOAL. This shot, high over the crossbar, they score! Oh, there's some pinball wizardry right there! That's 336-774-4625. Full season ticket holders get guaranteed access to the 7-game ACCHL tournament in February. Again, that's 336-774-4625. 625. We'll be screaming now, we can be
heroes. One final time here on the Labatt Blue Coaches Show on April 2nd. I'm Zach DeBozart. Scott Brand's got a smart comment in the chamber.
Well, I do, but our coach isn't here. He was so upset. He just heard the fact that we were getting beat by the IceHawks. Two games going on, 10-1 in both games, and now he's rattled.
Oh, yeah. I'm really mad.
I would imagine so.
We're back skating tomorrow. We're doing the miracle drills.
And that's a couple of losses in a row now. I mean, if you count those as two losses, I think we're on a 3-game losing streak.
Well, it is against the Mites. The Mites beat us. The girls beat us last week.
Unbelievable.
Actually, it's so fun to watch, except when Stan's out there. Stan just can't turn it down. He just takes the puck away from the kids.
I'm just going to say, thank goodness we don't play these regular games on Tuesdays and Wednesdays. We just seem awful on them.
Yeah.
As we look real quick, we talked about the playoffs, but the remainder of the FHL schedule finishes out. Unfortunately, I guess you could say there's not really a whole lot of drama. We know 1 through 4. Really, the only drama is who finishes fifth, who finishes last, and even then, that doesn't matter much in the grand scheme of things. There is, because Menor is only 3 points down at Danville, and Danville plays one more game, so a tie would actually go to the Icebreakers at that point. So
why?
Because points percentage, 59 games versus 58, if the raw points are the same.
59 games, 58.
Yeah, so Watertown travels to Menor on a Thursday night game, 7:35, Thursday, April 4th. This was a game that was supposed to be played in the opening weekend of the season, but had to be pushed back due to some other local conflicts. And, well, they eventually found a weekend. It was the last weekend of the season.
And knock on wood, this could be the first year out of 10 seasons the FHL plays all of its games.
There you go. On Friday, Watertown will then host Elmira. Port Huron will travel to the Menor Civic Ice Arena to take on the Icebreakers. Of course, we are in Danville, Illinois. And then Saturday, your final games on the final day of the regular season. Carolina Thunderbirds host the Danville Dashers. Watertown Wolves host the Port Huron Prowlers. Menor Icebreakers host the Elmira Enforcers. One final battle of the expansion franchises, which Scott and Andre, as we've both learned, that's becoming something of a rivalry, those two expansion teams.
Oh, there's no doubt about it. I mean, they both play on the edge. Let's put it that way.
What's it called? They got that little hate.
Yeah, it is hate.
And Elmira's embracing that now. Did you hear?
Yes, I heard that. By the way, did you hear about the dog that gave birth on the side of the highway?
Oh, no. Oh, no.
She was ticketed for littering. You know what? I had to say that because Randy Simpson's coming up next. He steals all my jokes. And then he won't play Funky Worm for me.
All right. Well, there you go. There you go. Big thanks, Scott Brand, Andre Neach, for joining us, and Richard Miller for keeping us on the air all show long. I'm Zach DeBozart, the voice of the Thunderbirds. We'll see you next from Danville, Illinois, on a 7:40 Eastern pregame show right here on WTOB. You've been listening to the Labatt Blue Coaches Show on
WTOB, Winston-Salem.
We'll see you Friday night. Have a good one, flock.
tonight's Labatt Blue Coaches Show was brought to you by Labatt Blue, Get Undomesticated. McAnally's, home of the 45-cent wing night every Monday and Wednesday. Forsyth Tech, break away from the pack. Oaks Animal Hospital, dogs, cats, and Thunderbirds, they fix them all. By BJ's Restaurant and Brew House, home of the world-famous Pizookie dessert. Finnegan's Wake, the Triad's favorite Irish pub and eatery. King's Hot Dogs, home of the King Dog. As Good As It Gets, the official salsa provider of the Carolina Thunderbirds. Carlisle's Pub, your friendly neighborhood tavern. Britton Chiropractic, the official chiropractor of the Thunderbirds. By Washington Park Barbershop, located at 2104 Broad Street in Winston-Salem. And by Pat's Body Shop and Towing, the official towing provider of the Thunderbirds and the Fairgrounds Annex. This has been a presentation of the Carolina Thunderbirds Hockey Club.